Welcome friends, I welcome you in the lecture, video lecture on design of pressure vessel part 3. So first of all, we'll discuss the important points to be remembered before solving type 1 numericals. So in this lecture, we are going to solve the type 1 numericals, and these are some points which are very important from numerical point of view. So in the last lecture, I have told you about this design pressure. So design pressure is actually more than the actual internal pressure. That is, it is more than the operating pressure. This design pressure, that is PI, is equal to 1.05 times of operating pressure. So operating pressure will be given in the numerical. So from this operating pressure, you need to calculate the design pressure by multiplying 1.05 to the operating pressure. So this is the first very important point. The second, sigma T. It is the allowable tensile stress for plate material in Newton per mm square. Remember that many times this allowable tensile stress for the plate material is directly given. So you don't need to calculate this. You can directly use that allowable tensile stress value. But if it is not given, you need to find out by using equation SYT upon FS. Now for a ductile material, if this FS, if FS is not given for a ductile material in the numerical, you need to assume or use FS is equal to 1.5. If FS for ductile material is not given in numerical, you need to assume FS is equal to 1.5. Similarly, for a brittle material, sigma T is equal to SUT upon FS. Now here, for brittle material also, if FS is not given, assume FS is equal to 3 for a brittle material. Sometimes this value of FS will be given in the numerical, or sometimes it will not be given. Sometimes in the numerical, the whether material is ductile or brittle, that will not be also mentioned. So by looking at the value of this strength, you need to conclude. That is, if the SYT is given, that means it is a ductile material. And if SUT is given, that means it is a brittle material. So by looking at this strength, whether it is a yield strength or ultimate strength, you need to select the value of corresponding FS. That means if the SYT is given, that means it is a if yield strength is given, that means SYT is given, it is a ductile material. So you need to assume FS is equal to 1.5 if FS is not given. Similarly, if in the numerical SUT is given, that is ultimate tensile strength is given, but FS is not given, then you can assume FS is equal to 3 as it is a brittle material. So this is the second point. Now third, as we seen in the last lecture, the corrosion allowance is very important and that need to be considered while calculating the thickness of cylindrical shell or spherical shell or enclosures. So this corrosion allowance, if it is not given in the numerical, you can assume CA is equal to 1.5. Its unit is mm. Similarly, if weld joint efficiency, it is also important because we know that these cylindrical shells or spherical shells or these enclosures, these all parts are manufactured by welding. So these plates are bent and then these are joined together to form the pressure vessel or a cylindrical shell or spherical shell or to join the enclosure. So this joint efficiency must be given. If it is not given, you can assume eta is equal to 0.85 in the numerical. So these are the some important points about this type 1 numericals. Then we'll see the first type of numerical. A statement is, a cylindrical shell of internal diameter of 2 meters is subjected to an operating pressure of 1 Newton per mm square. The allowable tensile strength of plate material is 150 Newton per mm square and corrosion allowance is 2 mm. The welded joint efficiency is 85%. Torispherical enclosures are used having crown radius of 1.8 meters. And determine thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torispherical enclosure. So this is the problem. So first of all, we'll write the given data. So first, in the first sentence or in the first line, it is given that internal diameter of this cylindrical shell is given. So first of all, we have to write it is a cylindrical shell. Then internal diameter is given, that is a DI equal to 2 meters. Convert it into mm by multiplying 1000. Then operating pressure is given, it is 1 Newton per mm square. So write down operating pressure is equal to 1 Newton per mm square. Now here the allowable tensile strength is directly given. Remember, allowable tensile strength is denoted by sigma t. So sigma t is given 150 newton per mm square. Before that, you have to find out this design pressure. So design pressure Pi is given by 1.05 into operating pressure. So operating pressure is 1. Operating pressure is 1. So put operating pressure here. So you can get the value of design pressure Pi. So its value is 1.05 newton per mm square. So this is the design pressure. Now this allowable tensile strength sigma t directly given 150 newton per mm square. You can write it. Then corrosion allowance Ca is given. So it is 2 mm. Then welded joint efficiency eta is given 85%, that is 0.85. And end closure type is given. It is torus-spherical end closure. So right here or mention here the type of enclosure. It is a torus-spherical enclosure. And its crown radius, that is capital L, is given 1.8 meters. Convert it into mm. So it is 1800 mm. Now at the end, write down, calculate the parameters that needs to be determined. So first is thickness of cylindrical shell, and second is thickness of torus-spherical enclosure. So this is the numerical. So we'll start solving this problem. So first of all, write down solution. In that, write down first point, the thickness of cylindrical shell. Now we have seen the equation of cylindrical shell thickness in the last lecture. So use it. So we know that the thickness of cylindrical shell is given by equation. TCS is equal to PIDI upon twice sigma t eta minus PI plus CA. Now let us look at the given data and compare this parameter. So PI, design pressure, it is given, or we have calculated it, 1.05 newton per mm square. PI is design pressure, we have calculated. DI, internal diameter, it is given. Sigma T, allowable tensile stress, it is also given, 150. Then eta, efficiency of weld joint. So efficiency of weld joint is also given, 0.85. This is a design pressure, and this is corrosion allowance. It is also given 2 mm. So by putting all the values and calculate this thickness of cylindrical shell, its answer would be 10.26 mm. So this is our first answer. Now write the second point, the thickness of torus-spherical enclosure. So type of enclosure is torus-spherical enclosure, and its thickness we have to determine. So we know that the thickness of spherical enclosure is given by equation. So T is equal to 0.885 PIL upon sigma T into eta minus 0.1 PI plus CA. So here design pressure PI is given. Already we have seen crown radius capital L is also given. It is 1800 mm. Then allowable tensile stress sigma T is given. Efficiency of weld joint eta is given. This is again a design pressure PI, and corrosion allowance is also given. It is 2 mm. So by putting all the values here and calculating the answer of this thickness of torus-spherical enclosure, its answer would be 15.12 mm. So this is our second and final answer of this problem. So with this problem, our first problem solution is completed. So remember here we have calculated here two parameters, thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torus-spherical enclosure. So in this very important point is this design pressure we need to calculate, and allowable tensile stress is directly given, so we don't need to calculate the allowable tensile stress. So this is a simple problem. Now similar basis, we'll solve the second problem. Now read the problem. The cylindrical shell is subjected to an internal operating pressure of 1.2 MPa. So operating pressure is given 1.2 MPa or 1.2 Newton per mm square. The yield strength of plate material is 200 Newton per mm square. Remember here the yield strength is given, that means it must be a ductile material. Then the corrosion allowance Ca is given 2 mm. It is a spot or radiographed. So radiography is carried out to find out the defects in the welded joint. It is a double welded butt joint. Actually, it is not required for numerical. Then it is used to fabricate the shell whose internal diameter is 2.5 meters. So internal diameter DI is given 2.5 meters. Then type of enclosure is given torus spherical heads, each with crown radius of 2 meters. Crown radius is given, and this crown radius is only for torus spherical heads. For other two types of enclosures, this parameter is not there. Then determine the thickness of cylindrical shell and torus spherical shell. So this problem is similar to the previous problem. Only difference is that here the yield strength of plate material is given, and as this material is yield strength is given, so this material is a ductile material, and for a ductile material we need to assume Fs if it is not given. So let us first of all write down the given data. So first it is cylindrical shell is mentioned, so write down cylindrical shell because we need to use the cylindrical shell thickness formula. So write down this first cylindrical shell. Then internal operating pressure. Operating pressure is given 1.2 MPa or Newton per mm square. Immediately calculate design pressure PI. So design pressure is equal to 1.05 into operating pressure. Operating pressure is 1.2. So by putting the value of operating pressure and calculating, we'll get the operating pressure PI is equal to 1.26 Newton per mm square. Now next, the yield strength of plate material is 200. So SYT is given 200 Newton per mm square. So now calculate allowable tensile stress. So this is very important part. Sigma T is allowable tensile stress. Its formula is SYT upon FS. And we know that as this is a SYT is given, that means it is a ductile material. So assume Fs is equal to 1.5. Remember here, sometimes the Fs will be also given. So at that time, the given value of Fs needs to be used. But here the Fs is not given. So we need to assume Fs 1.5 for ductile material. So calculate this. So allowable tensile stress would be 133.33 Newton per mm square. So this is allowable tensile stress. Now next, corrosion allowance CA is given 2 mm. Then DI, internal diameter, is given 2.5 meters. Convert it into mm, so it is 2500 mm. Then type of enclosure we need to mention here. So type of enclosure is torus spherical enclosure, each with crown radius of 2 meters. So crown radius is denoted by capital L. So capital L is equal to 2 meters is equal to 2000 mm. And we have to find out the thickness of cylindrical shell and the torus spherical head. If you look at all this problem statement here, the efficiency of weld joint is not given. So here efficiency of weld joint is not given. So therefore assume eta is equal to 0.85, and we have to calculate these two parameters, thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torus spherical enclosure. So this problem is similar to the previous problem. Difference is that efficiency we have to assume here, and here SYT is given instead of direct allowable tensile stress, and we have to assume Fs to calculate this sigma t. So now solution. So first, thickness of cylindrical shell. So we know that the thickness of cylindrical shell is given by equation TCS is equal to PI DI upon twice sigma T N minus PI plus CA. So PI of design pressure, it is 1.26 Newton per mm square. DI, it is 2500 mm. Sigma T, it is 133.33 Newton per mm square. Efficiency eta, we have assumed it as 0.85. Again, PI, it is a design pressure, and CA, corrosion allowance given 2 mm. So by putting all these values and calculating the thickness of cylindrical shell, the answer will be 15.97 mm. So this is our first answer of this second numerical. Now the second parameter is thickness of torus spherical enclosure. Now we know that the thickness of torus spherical enclosure is given by equation T is equal to 0.885 PIL upon sigma T eta minus 0.1 PI plus CA. So this is the equation for thickness of toy spherical enclosure. Now design pressure PI is given 1.26, or rather we have calculated this crown radius capital L is given 2000 mm. Sigma T we have calculated 133.33. Eta we have assumed efficiency of weld joint as 0.85. PI is again design pressure, and CA corrosion allowance is given 2 mm. So by putting all these values and calculating, we'll get the answer of this thickness of toy spherical enclosure as 21.70. So this is the thickness of toy spherical enclosure. So this is our second and final answer of this second numerical. So for this numerical, remember that this efficiency of weld joint needs to be assumed as it is not given, and calculating this sigma t by assuming fs as syt is given. It is a ductile material, so we need to assume fs as a 1.5. so with this problem, our this video lecture is completed. So thanks for watching this video lecture. If you have any query, please mention in the comment section. So thank you.